We're not going to talk about that.
The big wooden house in which they live.
Blamed for the darkness, Brother Goblin was forced to leave the forest, while his sister had to stay behind.
Decided to confront the darkness in the big wooden house.
Though they sought the help of their friends in the forest, they found that no one wanted to delve into the long-gone past.
This is how the goblins found themselves alone, trying to discover what darkness had submerged the big wooden house.
So yeah, last episode we found out that she killed their mother, like she did the final blow, and he just took the fall for her.
Tomorrow we should play Compass and North Star in the woods. Be sure to wear your hat then. You be sure to wear your hat. Alright, who wants ice cream?
Me!
Eat up.
She was no longer truly a princess in a tiara and a beautiful gown, but a wanderer, a loner, and a deep intention. And that was how the princess lost her most precious treasure. And
I don't like this. There were no goblins, and it was depressing.
I won't read it again.
I love you, Mom. Not me. Just kidding. Love you, Mom.
I love you too.
Alright. Well, that's... I felt like there was going to be a plot twist, but I honestly didn't think that it would be Allison that killed her.
Not letting ourselves do this again. Come on, up. Mind-numbing labor is a great way to forget your troubles.
Can't we just have coffee instead?
No. On your feet, soldier. Let's take a break from packing and sort out the furniture. If we get enough done, I'll drive you into town and buy you a gallon of ice.
I'm in.
Mint chocolate chip, 2 gallons. Let's do this. Goblin face is key. Dollar sign is donate or sell, and trash can as well. Trash. By the way, I cleared out most of the stuff.
On the table and the lobby chair. We can make some pretty good money if we sell this. And I know I'd end up eating on the couch most of the time anyway.
What's that smell?
she needed was a little nudge to get her along.
And Kennedy, hero of some kind.
I remember being super impressed by her. And maybe you ought to be a wild animal superhero too.
You hungry? We have a whole lot of nothing. We are all out of pickles today. Did I interest you in a ketchup-only sandwich? Looks like there's still a bottle back here.
Ew.
Says the guy who used to eat peanut butter with ranch. Ancient appliances, you have some. Well, that oven looks in okay shape.
How do you expect to take that apart? Do I have to get rid of anything over here? Tyler, get out of my way.
No stains, folks.
What happened?
Some unfortunate spillage that brought about the end of indoor tea parties. I hid the stain with my toys, forgetting that they would eventually be picked up.
Brilliant.
Well, I seem to recall a time you stole an egg, put it on the couch, and sat on it because you wanted a pet chicken.
Well, at least I can understand.
I guess it's finally time to take these pictures down.
Yeah. We're deciding what to do.
I mean, most of them are pretty happy memories.
I guess.
You look cute here.
That's not me. I mean, it is, but...
Like, not really. I get it.
It's just weird. Seeing myself like that.
Yeah.
Didn't think a picture could throw me like this anymore.
I'm sorry. That sounds really rough.
Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm like 1,000 times better. Got a ways to go before I'm comfortable taking my shirt off. Which is why I'm scheduling my top surgery as soon as we send this house. No more putting a binder on every morning. God, it sounds fucking amazing.
Yeah, totally. Just so you know, I'll be there to help out when you do it. Whatever you need.
Thanks.
Alright. What's your verdict, Ronan?
You know what? I'll keep it here. To remind us how far we've come.
This one.
Why do I look so pissed? I remember loving this.
Maybe because Marianne was sticking a camera in your face?
Fuzzy.
You're just being bratty.
Was I, though?
Yes. All I did was help clean it when we were out on the porch. Eddie had to force me to share.
No, don't touch a man's fish.
What to do with this? Tables are expensive. And besides, this one's an Allison and Tyler original.
New collectible, the big frog. We like frogs.
I can completely forgot we had a pet bull for a few days. Everywhere I look, there's just stuff, stuff, and more stuff. Hello, ancient broken down machines. That will be the future owner's problem.
I mean, there might be something. Don't see us keeping anything in here, though.
What about that dresser?
You want your clothes or us to go for it?
Fair enough.
Fair enough. Junkyard.
So is the only thing we're gonna have to keep for ourselves just the table?
What do you know? More stuff. Five little monkeys jumping on the bed. Hey Tyler, how does five little monkeys go again? Five little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell down and bumped his head. You scared me to death when you fell out of that tree. I cried most of the way to Tessa's house. I remember the look that Tessa gave her when she finally came home. The looks could kill, right? There's a paper plane stuck in the ceiling light.
Maybe it has a secret message from our past self. Find something to knock it down.
Could use that ball. Okay, let's see if I can still do this. Oh, shut up.
Well, I guess that's no for the airplane.
Baloney. Guess who I found? Baloney.
Gotta keep those.
We should gather up all our old toys and give them to charity. I said we should give our old toys to charity.
Good to Ollie from Allison. Others may not understand the laughs we have together and love we share for each other, but I know whatever happens, every goblin has a twin. I love you. Happy Siblings Day. Aw, that's sweet. Let's see here, what else? Dearest Ollie, how are you? I'm in the boathouse and everything is going very well. I am writing this letter to formally invite you to my tea party. I will prepare tea and cookies. You can meet my dearest friend Bologna, who I know you will love. Please come this afternoon at 4. Kind regards, Allison. Dear Allison, thanks so much for the invitation. Everything is going good. Everything is good here too. No beavers in sight though. I will be there at 4:15 because I need to make sure to feed the birds or mom will go crazy. See you soon, Sir Ollie. That's cute.
So long, trusty dog beds.
Congratulations, you found the map that will lead you with no mishap. Follow the trails of twinkling stones and perchance you'll escape the unknown. See anything else that was... Don't talk to me, Tyler.
Nope. There's way too much junk to sort through.
I've already looked under there, though. Goblins were here.
Allison, I asked you to clean up the coffee table 3 times already.
Oops, I forgot.
I don't remember that. Come on, let me clean it.
All right, I'll clean it up.
Thanks. I'll check out the furniture. I'm guessing you want to keep the coffee table?
Yes.
Yeah. Is that okay?
Sure. I'm not really planning on bringing furniture to the Nolan. And if I need a base in Juno, you'll have all the furniture I need.
A very non-committal view. Alright, I'll keep it.
Okay, I'm done.
I really like that armchair.
Maybe sit in it for a few minutes and see if you get used to the mold smell first.
Second thought, never mind.
Maybe it'll be salvageable with a deep clean?
Are you gonna keep doing that?
What, the cow?
Yes, you are.
Yes, absolutely.
Say it, but can't just get a one-way ticket to the dump.
No protest here. I think I have permanent knee damage from a decade of bumping into the corner of those damn things.
Well, then that's it for living. You are relieved from your duties.
Jump up and do the cha-cha.
What about me? I want to clean the fish too. It's not even your fish. You didn't catch anything. Ugh. Only because you went into that pocket and scared all the fish away.
Keep your eyes on what you're doing. Allison, when we're done with this, you can take over and do the other one. That sounds great.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
I wonder if my horse figurine is still in there.
Your what?
Your what now?
You know, my blue toy horse. With the kind of melted face. The one you stole from me.
What? That never happened.
Yeah, it did. I won it at that little Halloween carnival they had at the school every year. You grabbed it and hid it in the pot. Then when I tried to get it back, you said there was a snake inside too.
Whoa. Hold on. I think I remember the snake part, but you didn't win that horse. I did. And you were crying because you hadn't won anything, so I gave it to you.
That makes no sense. Why would you hide it if you gave it to me?
Because kids are kids.
Hey, lean free. You want coffee?
Starting the fire again?
Yeah, I'm gonna boil some water. You want something to drink?
Sure. Oh, coffee.
I'd rather have instant coffee or instant coffee.
Nah, sorry. I'm more of a tea person. Get it? Tea.
That's, I get it.
How long have you been waiting to make that joke?
Longer than I'm willing to admit.
I'm so glad Eddie came through on the caffeine.
Shh, did you hear that?
The Ice King is sending us a warning.
I wouldn't be so sure that that's not true.
My dark and twisty version was better.
We put so many hours into that book.
Yeah. The binder was full of extra drawings and incomplete stories. I think they're all still in the kitchen drawer.
We should go for the one.
Look in there. Oh, Tyler's gonna do it.
Hey, Allison. Allison's first drafts. Right. I didn't contribute at all.
Come on. I know you did. I can't believe she kept all these.
You think putting them on the fridge for a couple of weeks would have been enough?
You know how we thought of ourselves as the goblins? Did you ever get the sense that maybe Marianne was the princess in the stories?
Yeah. She called her bedroom the princess's sanctum, and she was all alone in the woods, in his house, until we showed up.
She was. Alone. But with a few friends who helped her along the way.
What are you doing?
Research. So, if Marianne was the princess, then who were all the rest?
And here we go.
Oh, come on. Humor me.
You have Tessa, Ed, and Sam. Well, Sam is the one that liked to fish, right?
You go here.
Which one was the one that... Once Upon a Time in a Deep... I can't read that very well. Once upon a time in a deep ancient forest, the princess was melancholy because it was the 1-year anniversary of when she ran away from home. Sensing her sadness, her forest friends showed up at her door. They were headed by the pelican, pious and attentive, and organized by the moose, stalwart and farsighted. I think the moose might be Tessa. The old bear was there, his claws so sharp, as well as the big frog prattling away. Even the haunty muskrat who mostly came out. Okay, so the bear invited her to ride on his back, promising no wolf would hurry her path. Then the animals led her to the fairy glen. Only the muskrat had done nothing in particular, mooching off of everyone else. The princess said she had a good time. She forgot to say thank you. Noticing this, her fairies. Okay, because you have taken your friends for granted. We have hidden them from you, but like games, guess who has given you each of these presents and you will have your friends back. Someone wants to make sure I don't get lost in the woods. That's the bear, which is Tessa, I think. She opened the second box and moose. The moose is Tessa. And then she opened the second box inside of his magic sword, which would leap right out. Someone wanted to make sure it's protected. Well, I mean, Ed is a police officer. Is that not correct?
Alright, I think I'm done.
You sure?
Yes.
How do you like that, Alex?
I mean, yeah, sure, maybe. What about these guys? I don't see them being there like people. Or this one.
The specific human attributes you have assigned to these forest animals are truly thought-provoking.
Indubitably.
Yep. Totally Maria.
Why a princess then? Why not a queen?
You better hurry, or the Mad Hunter will catch us! We need to hide. This way!
I don't like that.
I forgot about that.
I don't like that.
He was there.
No. Suddenly he was.
That was the only time it happened, right? Allison? Wait. It felt way too real. It was...
us. Pushing our imagination way too far.
That's what they all say.
Great. Sam Kansky, Grandmaster of Bad Timing. We're not done with this conversation.
Morning, Sam.
Ahoy, goblins. I ran into Chief Brown. He said you were starting to clean up on the house this morning, so I kind of figured you might need some supplies.
That's... thank you. That was very thoughtful.
Oh, also got something for you, Tyler.
Nice.
Every man needs a good knife. There you are.
Thanks, Dad.
Good. Good.
I mean, at least he's trying compared to the last time that we talked to him.
The lady of the house. It was your mom's favorite recipe. Still make it darn near every week.
Thanks. But we don't have a stove. Still not with electricity.
Oh, yeah. Fuse box is busted. Just another thing I've been meaning to put back together around here.
Where is it? I can take care of it.
Oh, I don't doubt you can. But, I've been kicking this thing back to life for the last 20-some years. I'll give you a hand.
All right.
Box is in the barn. Follow me.
We'll be right behind you.
I'm sure he didn't mean anything by that, if I'm being honest.
guess old bears can learn new tricks.
Yep. Come on. Let's go get our electricity back.
At least then you guys will both will both know how to do it in case it goes back out. Do I need to open it?
So, how's school?
I graduated on outdoor studies.
Oh, outdoor studies. Well, good thing I came along when I did. You know, I built this here barn for your mama.
We need to get as much info as we can.
I was glad to help. Your mother, she... I never bring myself to leave her high and dry. Anyways...
Just open the door.
And give us our keys. All of them.
No, I figured I might still need to do some maintenance, so...
Nope. We're good.
Fair warning. It was a bit temperamental.
Haven't you been taking care of this place? You didn't oil the doors?
What? You think I just hang out here all day or something? Here's some. Give me a try.
Good.
Okay, when you twist it as far as you can to the left, give it a nice little jerk.
Damn it.
No shit.
Well, it's open.
No. You and you are going to clean up your mess. I'll take care of the fuse box.
But I didn't do it.
I'm not asking. Go on. All right. Fuse is going to box. Is it enough?
Probably should read this before I break something. Main and the range, and then... Heater, kitchen, outlet, lights, generator. I wrapped up your electrical board. I got a run, but in case you want to check it out, careful not to overload the circuits. You'll have to use 15 for the garage, 120 for the whole house. I'm pretty proud of myself. Okay, so I need 15 for the garage. And then next, the garage is number 6. One, two, three, four, five, 6. So for the rest of it, we needed 120, so let's go 30, 60, 90. 90 plus 30 is 120, isn't it? Yeah. So 120 divided by 2 would be 60. That doesn't sound right. I don't think I have that divided the right way. I need a piece of paper. I need to sketch this out. So if I have... I need 120 total. Let's see here. The garage needs... What was it? 15? Amps for the garage. So let's just place a 15 to play safe. Mm. So for the house, we need 120. Let's see here. So we have a 30, a 20, and a 15. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 spots. 120 out of 4. That would be 4 goes into 12 3 times, and then 0. So it would be 30 altogether. That's 215, so... Oops.
I'm moving at my own pace. I need to know this stuff.
Yes, I read the note. I'm just not good at math. What's 20 times 2 is 40 plus 15 would be 55, and then I have a 30 in there, which would be 85. I think that's counting the 15 for that, so if I add another 15... that would be 100, and then I can add a 20. Okay, so 15, and then I needed a 20. There you go, 120. How?
I guess I should try a higher ramp use. Just do the math.
I did do the math. What do you mean do the math? Oh, don't tell me they correspond with the chords.
Let's try this one.
Wrong one. Let me remove that red one. Let's just put a 30 in there.
Just do the math, Alice.
Yellow. Need a 20 in this one. Why is there... because that white cord matches the one down there that says 25. Well, clearly all of them need a fuse.
Hey, what did I say?
I'm trying. Trying. Oh, so now it lets me remove it. I'm tired of this. Okay. With a match.
Seems good.
Now that I just did math for no reason.
Okay.
Probably because he's seen where the gun goes, but...
I wonder why Sam got so upset.
Something actually got to him, smart one.
Well, something about it really got to him.
I don't think any of us are exactly happy to see the gun. Remind me to take the gun.
Oh, look at this. I think this is where she made out. She was so crafty. Toilet paper tubes, rope, cardboard.
Maybe a car? Ooh, or a tank.
Right on the left. What's that? Ew, what?
Why not?
Hey, it was not funny.
Sure thing, B-boy.
Hey there, little buddy.
Are you cooing at a spider? And it better be a tiny one.
Don't listen to the mean lady. You're an eight-legged pew.
What are we gonna do with this one?
Take her apart, subtract.
Alright.
Be my guest. It sure looks like a pile of junk to me.
Gotta get money somehow.
I see dollar. I put together the sweetest toolbox ever.
Hey, you do that, buddy.
Found Marianne's stash. Blueberry. Blueberry. Salmonberry. Huh. Punch and fuzz have definitely gone bad.
As far as...
Does canned food really expire? I mean, it's airtight, right?
Not gonna be the one to test that out.
Fair. So what's the objective here?
Allison.
What did you find?
Do you know who that is?
Yeah. That's Carol, Eddie's mom. I've seen other pictures of her, but never this one.
Yeah, look at Brown. And then she looks really happy.
Can I?
Careful, the glass is broken.
Are you okay? It's stainless. Let's go see Mom. Don't you get mad. You weren't even supposed to be here.
Well, what happened here? Make what call?
Can't figure out what's going on.
I don't know. I remember that whatever Eddie had to do, whatever that call was about, it was tearing him
up. Tearing him up? He was being a total cop, and Marianne got pissed and threw him out. Here, I'm gonna show you what I remember. There, by the house.
I can see that happening.
I said get out! Out!
What? She didn't throw the picture at him.
Are you sure about that? He's being a complete dick.
How can you be sure? We were eavesdropping. We could barely see a thing.
What do you think happened then?
What I'm legally required to do.
Why are you here? Pretty sure this is...
I wanted you to hear it from me.
Please.
I believe Tyler on this one. Mostly because I don't like Eddie.
Why do you keep remembering the same thing so differently?
It was a long time ago. Well, memory is a tricky thing.
When did that happen?
I'm not sure. I think it was the exact same day she attacked you.
That's what I thought.
Uncle Eddie said he hadn't seen Marianne for weeks.
Yeah, that was bullshit. And what was all that about following the law? What was he doing here exactly?
I have no idea.
I don't know. I have no idea. We shouldn't jump to any conclusions.
I will jump as far as I want.
But that doesn't make him incapable of lying.
I can't see him being that cold with me. Even if he was being caught.
I mean, I can. Who knows? Guess memory's a tricky thing.
To be fair, you guys were both in different mindsets during these memories. And so, depending on how the two of you were feeling, it could easily vary your memory of it.
And then lied about it. Now what?
Go and get a straight answer from him.
Right now?
Yes. I'll go get my car keys.
But what would these mountains of trash do without us?
Fucking trash.
What happened to my ice cream? I was promised ice cream. Well, I mean, Tyler was promised ice cream. I have ice cream.
Talking about the truth and the law and shit.
Do you have to be so happy about it?
What?
I know you've been waiting for something like this. Something that proves Eddie's an asshole. But gloating about it is really not cool. Oh, it's tedious. Yeah, just a sec. I'm parking the car.
Who's Tina?
Go stretch my legs then.
No. Just give me a second. Okay, Tina. What's going on?
Hi, hon. I've got someone with some words to see the house.
Oh, that's amazing. When? That, but we've kind of got a lot going on over here.
Did I mention
we're
leaving all the cash on the
floor? Let's do it.
Do it.
Yeah?
Yep.
Great. I'll set it all up, messed up, send you the details. Later, hon.
I feel like I should have talked to Tyler about it, but, you know. Warning. Bear encounters are frequent during Salmon Run, May through October. Exercise extreme caution along all rivers, local trails, viewpoints, and glacier roads. During autumn, bears move to higher elevations to feed on berries and den for the winter. Do not feed the bears. Keep all foods properly stowed and contained. Stay alert. Learn to spot fish and game carcasses and scavengers. Make noise while hiking. Bears don't like surprises. Never hike alone. Always carry pepper spray when hiking. In case of encounter, do not run. Stand your ground. Wave your arms. Talk loudly. Do not climb trees or poles. Bears are very efficient climbers. In case of violent attack, fight back vigorously. I don't think that's what you should be telling people. I mean, I guess if you have to protect yourself, then sure, but you know.
Dee and I did that trail a couple of years ago. We drank ice cold beers when we reached the summit. Whose hearts are you looking to win out there, Tom? The bears?
Aw, look at it.
They are just really nailed this one.
That is adorable.
Kind of rings a bell.
That is adorable. I love that.
Looks like you found a nice spot.
You've been here before, right?
I don't know.
So, Tina?
Tina West, our realtor?
Oh. What'd she need?
Well, we have an interested buyer. Tina's gonna show him the house day after tomorrow.
Well, great.
Apparently he'd be paying cash, but he's just in town for a few days. I mean, we're not signing anything in blood. It's just a showing.
I know.
Boy, we both need this money. And it'll take at least a few weeks. Plenty of time to figure out all this million stuff.
It's fine. You did it. It's done. Let's move on. So, before Tina called, we were talking.
Yeah.
I'm not happy your foster father fucked up.
Oh yeah? Because you sure sounded like
he
it.
He hid information about Marianne.
I know! You just don't have to rub it in.
I get it. You're always gonna side with him over me.
Come on, that's not fair.
Then why do you keep doing
this? This town, these people, they're just memories to you. But it's my home, Tyler. My friends, my family.
That's not
and
fair.
As much as I want answers, I'd rather not lay waste to my entire life to get them.
He took the fall for you, not the other way around.
You're eager to ditch all those friends and family, Allison. Apparently a cash offer is all it takes.
I'm ready to move on. But that doesn't mean I want to burn every bridge on my way out.
Do we go there? Or... Oh, we're gonna go there. We're gonna get all of this out. You kind of did. No, let's see. That's how it feels, honestly. So, are we just gonna sit here? Yeah, it's called snow.
Found you! North Star! Okay, now
oh.
You're the star, and I'm the company. Okay, and don't cheat. I know you were sending me fake hints last night. Did you not? Yes, you did. Okay, okay, I won't do it again.
Always accusing me of cheating.
Because you totally did.
It was a cool game. Guessing where you were by feeling what you felt.
We look like a little freaks. No one else could play with us.
No one else could play with us.
That was the beauty.
For real? You never wanted any other friends?
Nah, not really. I mean, we had each other. That was enough for me.
Okay. I'm going to get my cell phone for 2 minutes, so we're not talking to you first.
It's okay. You probably made the right call. You were right to call me out earlier. I was being a jerk about it.
I'm all for enjoying the wins as they come, but maybe not at the expense of my father figure.
I'll try my best.
No, because if he's being a jerk about things, then we need to confront this. I'm sorry, but it's true. Alright, well, I think that's where I'm going to leave it for today. Let you guys have a good look really quick. We're gonna figure out what Eddie is hiding from us.
Look at that.
Next episode.
Crystal fog's taking over the summit.
Not sure when it's gonna be posted, but it should be pretty soon. Fair enough. But yeah, so I think that's gonna be it for cut. No. Stop. Okay. Yeah, I think that's gonna be it for today. So, yeah.